Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. Setting up your Mac is a big part of enjoying and getting the most of your sparkly new toy. So here are the 12 best must-have apps to make the most of your Mac. I won't be recommending, you know, the very usual typical apps like Google Chrome, Spotify, or Zoom. Come on guys, they're no-brainers, I would hope. So I'll share hopefully what are more unique and more interesting apps that have personally helped me over the years and I find genuinely really useful. Okay, so let's get stuck straight into the very first app. On my Mac now, Encrypto is the first must-have starter app that I think everyone should have, and it's completely free too. Basically, if you need to send or store files privately and safely, this is the app to have. It basically takes any file like this folder here, throw it in here, and it adds AES 256 encryption to it, which means only the right person with the right password can access the file. I use it to store important information on my MacBook and hard drives, like, you know, tax documents, that sort of stuff, and also sending confidential documents over email. I'll secure it with Encrypto before sending it over. It's super simple to use and the interface is really nice and clean. Basically, you just drag and drop the folder or the file into Encrypto, set a password for it, click Encrypt, and then it'll secure the file, and then you can save it or send it immediately. The other person on the other end basically receives the file and decrypts it with Encrypto, as you can see there, and then you access it. I don't use it that often, but when I do, it's just really, really useful and it just works. And by the way, I'll leave direct links to all the apps in the description box below for convenience. The next Mac app that I love and I want to share is Craft. It's a really useful note collaboration and note taking app that I use instead of Apple Notes. It's basically a more powerful and prettier version of Notes, and also just better made for collaborating. So whenever I have a meeting, or, you know, when I want to build out and type out notes, I'll just come into here, click the plus sign and click new document. And you get this really sort of clean interface to build out notes on. And I just love it because simply it's just a great editing tool. You know, there's tagging options and filing systems, and it just outright looks great. Dark mode on this app looks visually stunning, and so does the library of templates that I always pull from. If I click new document, you can come down here and click templates, and there's just a whole load of templates that look visually stunning. It saves you a lot of time too, and I always come in here, look for a template, start using it, and it's just really simple to use. There are lots of note-taking apps out there, but Craft is just super fast, minimal, and iOS native. It's an app that I like to use as my go-to note taker. Next up is the Dropover app, which solves the problem of, you know, trying to move around a lot of files or just some files around your Mac, especially with a trackpad, because some things like slip and, you know, it's just really hard to drag and drop multiple files. It's basically a drag and drop shelf extension. So let's say I want to attach a whole bunch of these photos here on my desktop. What I'll do is I'll get this and start shaking it. I'll drop the file here. Then I can drop multiple in here. And not only that, I can also drag and drop a whole bunch of different things, not just images, but I can go into Unsplash, a website even, and it's still showing up here. The shelf is a layer that is on top of everything. And I'll just grab this and start shaking it too. And I'll bring it over here. And I can just start collecting a whole bunch of different photos. And then I can all dump it into a single place, like an email, for example. I also use it to create quick drop over links that expire during a certain amount of time. If I want to share a file or multiple files really quickly to multiple people over a link straight from my desktop, I'll click the three buttons here and I'll go straight to either AirDrop, messages, or mail, or I can create a drop over link. I seriously can't tell you how many times I've tried to drag a bunch of files on my trackpad to have it dropped off elsewhere accidentally or not attach at all. Having this drop over shelf is probably the most simple app from this list, but it saved me minutes, if not hours, over the years since I got the app. Speaking of saving time, Clean My Mac X is another app that saves me a heap of time and also saves my Mac's hard drive space from being completely demolished and eaten up. And just a heads up, by the way, that Clean My Mac is sponsoring today's video. So thank you to Clean My Mac. I genuinely love this app because I've relied on it for, I guess, lack of better words, to clean my Mac. So one of the big reasons why I use Clean My Mac and why I'm recommending it as a must-have app is because on a Mac, when you delete an app by dragging and dropping the application into the bin, it doesn't exactly delete every single file. It'll leave around random files in case you do choose to reinstall the app that you deleted. But Clean My Mac does a far better job cleaning up the gigabytes of unused system junk and app files on your Mac quite properly. And aside from just deleting files properly, I use the Smart Scan feature every week, which is the feature that most people use from this app. If you just click this button here, scan, the app basically searches for ways to quickly improve the Mac's performance. And then once, that was pretty loud, so it just completed the scan. And once it's all done and complete, I'll click on the run button right here. So then basically it starts deleting system junk, malware, and flushing unused DNS. And it cleans up the system beyond just deleting unused apps and files. And continuing on from the theme of beautiful apps, while this cleans up my system again, the developers have seriously gone out of their way to design what is probably one of the best looking apps that I've ever seen on the Mac system, full stop. When I looked into it, the app has won a bunch of UX design awards, so no real surprises there. It just looks great in general. Definitely recommend Clean My Mac as a must-have to delete years worth of junk or to prevent it from being cluttered in the first place. You can try out the app for free in the link below and test out and see if it works for you. The next app is one I use literally multiple times a day, every single day, and it's called Xsnip. I don't know how it's pronounced. It's basically the best screenshot app that I've used on the Mac. I went through this phase a year ago where I was trying to find the best screenshot app, but most of them were just okay, and many of them slowed down my Mac for whatever reason, so I was just stuck to the trusty, you know, Mac Command Shift 4. But Xsnip is basically Command Shift 4 on steroids. There's a whole bunch of new shortcuts to get access. You get access to. So, for example, now that I press Command Shift 4 or Command Shift 9 in my case, I can, you know, do a whole bunch of things. I can like take a shot here. I can lock in the ratio. I can go one by one. I can go, you know, all sorts of shapes, all sorts of resolutions. And I can even edit the screenshot on the screen itself before saving it. So say if I had a text document, I can grab the highlighter app and, you know, start drawing on it. I can highlight things, I can add quick arrow annotations. And basically from there, you can either save it or you can copy it onto your clipboard. And probably most importantly, the app doesn't bloat your Mac and works just as smoothly as the native screenshot function. Next up, if you're a designer or creative in general, then Figma needs no introduction whatsoever. It's a powerful all-in-one design app that has absolutely mopped the floor with its competitors Sketch and Adobe XD. I use Figma to collaborate with my team on design projects or branding projects or just overall, just getting my thoughts into one place basically, and I'll show you how. This is an example of a brand book that we've created on Figma. And yeah, it's really neat. It's just a really powerful app. And let me know what you think of our redesigned channel branding below. This is it here. But yeah, even if you're not a designer, you'll find this app really useful because they have this thing called FigJam. If I get out onto the homepage again, FigJam within Figma is one of the better brainstorming and charting tools that I've used. So if you've ever planned out flowcharts or just need a huge whiteboard to collaborate on, to brainstorm on, FigJam and Figma are super useful tools. If you click the purple icon here, a new FigJam file, you get access to a whole range of templates. If you want to create a flowchart immediately, click this one here, and you can see here you get immediate access to this really easy to use flowchart. And it's a really great tool to start charting out thoughts, you know, putting sticky notes here and just getting your thoughts really clear. FigJam's great for that. Bartender here is an app that I've mentioned before on this channel, and one of the more recent tools that I find quite useful. It keeps the menu bar at the top here really minimal, which is the way I like it, instead of, you know, whole rows and rows of icons. It displays menu items and icons only when you need them by hovering over the menu bar. And then you get access to, you know, the rest of your icons here. And then there's also the options of triggers too, which I find so smart and useful. It basically shows specific menu items in certain situations. For example, the Wi-Fi icon appears only when you're not connected to a network, or the time machine icon only appears when it's actively backing up. You can switch those on here, and you can also turn on a whole load of different options and triggers here. There's also the infamous bartender bar that adds another row of hidden menu bar items, and you can have extra rows in general. Again, I think this is just another app that's just really easy to use. It is free as well. It looks good and it's feature rich. It saves you more space, but it still gives you fast access to apps. And you might indeed need this app itself by the end of this video, because I'm giving a lot of apps to download and use. Moving on to password management, my go-to free app I use is Bitwarden. I used to have LastPass about a year ago, but they've changed their pricing model, and Bitwarden basically does what I need it to for free. So that's why I switched over. It's essentially a password manager that securely holds all the keys to your digital life. The interface is pretty plain. I know that the interface is not as clean or as appealing as 1Pass or LastPass, but the community raves about Bitwarden, and I recommend it if you're looking for a completely free password manager on Mac that goes above and beyond the standard, you know, Apple keychain, saving passwords on your browser, or God forbid, using the same password across all your logins. The next app you're going to love if you're a Mac desktop user, or if you dock your Mac like I do, and it is up here, it's the Magnet app. And the Magnet app lets you resize windows however you like it, and really quickly with shortcuts too. So essentially you get a whole load of these shortcuts, and you can quickly snap and I guess that, hence the name, snap these windows into different places really quickly. So if I get two windows up here, for example, you know, instead of like dragging them and resizing them, I can hit Control Option to the side here, Control Option to the left, and we have these two nicely snapped in windows. I think Magnet is literally one of the most popular Mac productivity apps out there, and it's totally worth the small fee to save you a load of time and to resize things in so many different formats. I can also drag it to the side and it'll snap in automatically. But yeah, having window resizing tools and shortcuts can be extremely pleasing way to work. It allows for some really efficient workflow practices. And of course, I have to mention an app for gamers, good old Steam. I think we tend to forget that Macs are still capable of some light gaming, and I'm personally a casual gamer here and there when I want to unwind. And I'm not going to assume, by the way, that you know what Steam is. It's basically a digital gaming portal where you buy and play games from. You're definitely not going to get the entire gaming library selection, unlike on Windows, but there's still some decent Mac compatible games like Dota 2, Portal, and my personal favorite, Counter-Strike. But yeah, Steam is a great app to have on the side just in case you want to unwind and play some games. Next up is the photo editing app, Adobe Lightroom. This app is a no-brainer for those into photography or even casual enthusiasts who enjoy touching up photos. It's a powerful app that gives you a big range of controls to tweak your photos to your liking, with all the controls on the sidebar here and more. Yeah, and it takes advantage of your Mac's computing power. There's two versions, Lightroom Classic and the one that I'm using right here, Lightroom CC. I've migrated over to Lightroom CC and prefer it. They're both really similar. Classic has slightly more tools and controls, but Lightroom CC is basically better at everything else, including being connected to Adobe Cloud. The most useful feature is exactly that. It is the cloud syncing. So any photo editing that you do on your Mac is synced across every single device you access Lightroom on, including my iPad, for example. So yeah, killer must have app that helps me edit, organize, and manage all my photos. And then of course, how can I ever forget Notion? Notion is an all-in-one app when it comes to note-taking, collaboration, to-do lists, Kanban boards, and so much more. I don't even know how I'd survive without it. I have one for my personal use here. If I flip out, this one's for business. So I have multiple Notion boards, and like I said, I really don't know how to survive without it. I use Notion to organize my life, literally, and manage my businesses. And it's all cloud-based again. So when I jump back onto the iPad, for example, from my Mac, all the work is updated and synced. And yes, there are other Macs that may do certain things within Notion that much better. And there's even an overlap between Notion and Craft, the app that I mentioned earlier. But I personally appreciate having most things in one spot, and I'd sacrifice some benefits for this simplicity. If you're interested in how I've set up my Notion here and in both my business and personal, I made a full video on it and you can check it out in the description box below. So yeah, guys, these are the apps that I highly, highly recommend when you're starting out with your new Mac. And so go forth and start building out the rest of your apps. If there are any apps that you'd recommend, please do let me know in the comments. I am always on the hunt for new app recommendations and testing out all sorts of apps. I'll drop a video of how to set up my favorite app, Notion, on the side of the screen here. And also, if you're curious about my home office setup here, I'll also drop a video here too for you to check out, because I get loads of questions on my setup all the time. Drop the code word comment apples if you got to the end of the video, and subscribe for more tech and business videos. As always, thank you for watching and see you in the next video.